How often does a civilization occur? By studying that, we could look at stars that are suitable for the development of civilizations. How many new stars appear every year? 7. But some stars are too cold and some are too hot. Only about 20% can be considered as suitable. We all know that there are some factors for species and animals to survive and reproduce, including environmental conditions, temperature, tolerance range, body size, weight, diets, seasonal and daily activity, behavior, and the altitude they live. Animals migrate to find a new habitat because the change of environment, and only species that have the tolerance for new environment could survive and reproduce. Human beings are the only organism that makes extensive use of technology to extend the limits of its natural tolerance range.
Welcome to Stanford University Business School, which always promotes leadership in learning, management, and delivery of goods and services. We are not only delivering services but also making sure good quality. It is clear that educational purpose is to learn management and leadership. You should realize your own responsibility through accomplishing assignments by yourselves instead of depending on others. Profit and non-profit institutions like Stanford University provides learning, while business school is providing learning management. You should realize that the responsibility and accomplishments achieved by others don't indicate what you are capable of.
The debt today is so high. It's 200,000 rupees, 300,000 rupees of peasant who have no capital. They, who know within a year or two, when they accumulate the kind of debt, they will never be able to pay back. Where is the debt coming from? It's coming from a seed that is costing 100,000 to 200,000 rupees per kilogram, depending on what you got. Seed that used to be free, used to be theirs. Pesticides each time, the more they use, the more they have to use. 12 sprays, 15 sprays, 20 sprays. Pesticides used in just the last 5 years in the land areas of India has shot up by 2,000%. That's what the free market and globalization have brought. And since we are talking about peasants, who have no money, who have no capital, they can only buy expensive seeds and expensive pesticides by borrowing. And who lend them that money? The same companies that sell the pesticides, which are the same companies that sell the seeds, as you know, are now also the major creditors.
your job.